22nd, 2022. My name is Izzy. Happy birthday to Jonan in Mrs. Crook's class. Now stay tuned for the core value announcements about cooperation.
Ever heard the saying, teamwork makes the dream work? That saying sums up our March big idea and how we need to work together whenever possible to help make big things come to life. Cooperation is working together to do more than you can do alone.
Hello, Bearsville Elementary. I hope you enjoyed reading chapters 2 and 3 of Hildy Cracks the Case, Hero Dog. I've got another trivia question for you. What do the three meenagers call Hildy's newspaper? The real name is the Orange Street News, but the meenagers call it something different. Email those correct answers to Mrs. Elliott. The first three classes with the correct answer are the winners.
Hey kids, Hildy here with your vocabulary update for chapters 4 and 5. I hope you are enjoying the book. Today's first word is stammer. It was found on page 19. Here is a sentence. No, well, kind of, I stammered. And here is a definition of stammer. To speak with sudden stops and to repeat a word. Now here is our friend, Rudy the Rooster, to share our next word.
Thanks, Hildy. Our next word is coop. Its definition is a cage or pen to hold birds. The word can be found on page 20 in the following sentence. Would it be okay if I checked out your chicken coop? I asked. So a coop is actually my home. Thanks, Hildy, for letting me share about my house.
No problem, Rudy. Always good to have you. Now we have my friend Plate. He had an accident that he will tell us about.
Well, Hildy, our next word is scatter. The sentence, which can be found on page 24, helps to explain what happened. It says, I saw several cupcakes scattered near a broken plate. Yep, I'm the broken plate. The definition of scatter is to throw or spread in several directions. Hildy, do you have any glue?
Yes, Plate. I have some glue, and kids, I hope you are glued to the book and ready for chapter 6 and 7. See you soon!
Things that make you go, what? March 2nd, 1904. Theodore Geisel, better known to the world as Dr. Seuss, the author and illustrator of such children's books as The Cat in the Hat and Green Eggs and Ham, is born in Springfield, Massachusetts, on March 2nd, 1904. Geisel, who used his middle name, which was also his mother's maiden name, as his pen name, wrote 48 books, including some for adults, that have sold well over 200 million copies and have been translated into multiple languages. Dr. Seuss books are known for their whimsical rhymes and quirky characters, which have names like the Lorax and the Sneetches, and live in places like Whoville. Theodore Geisel graduated from Dartmouth College, where he was editor of school's humor magazine, and studied at Oxford University. There he met Helen Palmer, his first wife, and a person who encouraged him to become a professional illustrator. Back in America, Geisel worked as a cartoonist for a variety of magazines and in advertising. The first children's book that Geisel wrote and illustrated was called And to Think That I Saw It on Mulberry Street. It was rejected by over 24 publishers before making it into print in 1937. Geisel's first bestseller, The Cat in the Hat, was published in 1957. The story of a mischievous cat in a tall striped hat came about after his publisher asked him to produce a book using 220 new reader vocabulary words that could serve as an entertaining alternative to the school reading primers children found boring. Many Dr. Seuss books have been adapted for television and film, including How the Grinch Stole Christmas and Horton Hears a Who. Geisel published a book for adults titled Oh, the Places You'll Go that became a hugely popular graduation gift for high school and college students. Geisel, who lived and worked in an old observatory in La Jolla, California, known as the Tower, died September 24th, 1991, at the age of 87. Happy birthday, Dr. Seuss.
Let's end today's announcements by remembering the STAR expectations. Strive to do your best.
Take responsibility for your actions.
Always be safe.
Respect people and property. Have a great day, Bearsville.
Now please stand for the playing of the National Anthem, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance.